Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Has the Lord laid it on your heart to learn some new praise and worship tunes so that you can lead your small group in worship, or maybe even play on the praise team at your church? Well, if so, you've come to the right place. Hi, I'm Gaylerd, and the Lord has blessed me with an incredible gift to play the guitar. But you're never blessed just to keep that blessing to yourself. You're blessed to share it with others. So come on into the studio with me, and I'll share my blessing with you and teach you how to play Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just something about that name. You know, in the Bible, Philippians 2, verses 10 and 11 says that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. The day is coming that you and me will both bow our knees and confess with our tongues that Jesus is the Lord. Better to do it today than to do it then. You know, the Bible says, if today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. I hope that you've already accepted Jesus as your Lord. If not, then we'll have to talk. Send me a note and let's talk about Jesus. Right now, let me show you how to play the chords to this great song. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just something about that name. You know it's true, because I can't stop saying Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Okay, let me show you the chords that we're going to use. First of all, recognize that we're going to have the capo on the first fret, okay? You don't have to do it that way. I did it for vocal reasons. I like doing it in that pitch, but you don't have to. I've heard the Gaithers do it just in a regular D without that, but I'm just using that capo on there. That's entirely up to you. Okay, here's the chords that we're going to use. We're going to use a D, and I'll put this chord diagrams on there. I know it's hard to see. A D major 7, a D 7, a G, and you can play that G either way. I like it like that. Actually, it sounds a little fuller. I didn't do it that way, but with that second string, third fret, with your ring finger. You're going to play an E, an E7, an E minor 7, you can see that, an A7, okay. You're going to play an F sharp suspended 4. Now that sounds difficult, but it's not. An F sharp and an F sharp 7. Two more chords. You've got a B chord and a B7. And that's it. Now, through the whole song, that's all you got to play. Now let's go ahead and I'll show you how to do that intro. All right, I'm going to play that intro for you first, and then I'll show you how to play it. But this is played with the D chord formation. Okay, so what you're doing, you got that D, and we're going to get your D chord down there. You're going to play the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd string starting off. So it goes, I'll do the some tabs there for you. I'm going to do it real slow. okay? Just follow those tabs and you'll have that intro down. Now let me show you how to do the chords for the verses, for the verse when it starts off. Okay, the chords go, it's a D with Jesus, and all I'm doing there, Jesus, I'm picking 1, 2, 3. Now I never pick it the same way twice, so you got to remember that. So just do a picking pattern that's good for you. This particular one I'm going like that, okay? Jesus, Jesus. There's that D major, and on the chord I just give it that one strum. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just G, a G minor above that D. See how I'm picking up that picking action? I'm just picking those four strings. Master, Savior. That's that D major 7. G, D7. Now you go to an E7. Like the fragrance after the rain. I think I did that wrong. Like the fragrance after the rain. That's what it is. You got that E, fragrance. D major 7. Jesus, Jesus. Now you go into a G. Let all heaven. And here's that chord, that F sharp suspended 4. All you're doing there, it's like an A chord, but you've got it on the 5th, 4th, and 3rd string. In fact, what you want to do, if you want to put your fingers on the 5th, 4th, and 4th string, 2nd fret, and you're just moving it up 2 frets, okay? You're just moving that formation up 2 frets and putting your bar down there. There's your F sharp, right? So you got an F sharp, and you're making this a F sharp suspended, and that just has all those. What you're actually doing is that finger right there comes up 1 fret. But it's just easier to play it with your pinky, okay? And that's where he says, let all heaven, F sharp suspended 4, let all heaven and earth proclaim. There's an F sharp, and then I do a little 7th in there just to give it some flavor. Now you're going to your B chord. Kings and kingdoms will all pass away. That's an E7. But there's something, that's that E minor 7, about A7, that name. And that's it. That's all the chords, and you just keep repeating it. Why don't you play it with me one time? We'll play it together. You ready? Let's start it from the intro. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. There really is something about that name, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I hope you like that song. You know, I hope you enjoyed that song, learning that song. That's a great praise song to learn, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. But you know, when I shared earlier with you about Philippians 2, verses 10 and 11, it says, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. There is coming a day that each one of us is going to do that. I share that with you because the theme of my website and my YouTube channel, Gaylerd Guitar, is teaching guitar and reaching lives. I love to share what I know about the guitar and to teach the guitar, but I'd much rather teach you about Jesus and teach you about the Bible. And that phrase has always stuck with me, that one day there is going to come a time, there is actually going to come a time when you and I will stand face to face in front of the Lord. And if we confess Him now, we have eternal life. But at one day, if we don't confess Him now, if we don't live for Jesus, then there'll be a time that we will confess that He is Lord, that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Our knees will bow and our tongues are going to say it. And we'll recognize it then. We'll know it's the truth. Well, I'm sharing with you today that that is the truth. If you don't know Jesus, I encourage you to get into the Bible and read the Bible and start to pray. He's there. He thinks about us more times a day than there are grains of sand on the beach. I love that thought, you know, and that's biblical. That's what the Bible says. I want you to know that if you have a question about the Lord, if you'd like to know more about Jesus, just leave me a note down below. Tell me what you want to know. Not that I know it all, but I sure know where to look for the answers, and that's the Bible. You know, the Bible has every answer that we really need to know is in there. And I'm going to share this thought with you. You know, once you become a Christian, you realize that we don't really have to sin at that point. We choose to sin, but we don't have to sin. Because Jesus says, I'll give you the strength not to do it. I'll give you a way out. Every time you come into a situation, I'll give you a way out. So that means that if there were 10 times a day that you were going to sin, which one of those 10 times would He not be there for you to provide a way out? He's there every single time. But we choose to sin. My suggestion to you, what I encourage you to do, is every time that you have something that's causing you to sway away from the Lord, the Bible says, take control of your thoughts. Take control of your thoughts. Think about Jesus. Think about things that are pure, that are lovely. Think of those things. Those are all characteristics of Jesus. Think of Jesus, and I can promise you that you'll have the strength not to do whatever it is your flesh is wanting to do. Hey, I love you, but Jesus loves you more. And remember this, I don't know how much of Jesus you have in your heart, but I do know this, you've got all you want. I'll see you in the next video.
Subscribe now.